If you have a few polynomials, you can multiply them and work out the brackets to get one big polynomial. Maybe some effort, but not too difficult. Going back is a lot harder. Factorizing a big polynomial as a product of linear and quadratic terms, that can be very difficult. For larger polynomials, we even know that there's no general formula for this. So, why do we want to do this? Well, we need it, for example, when computing certain limits or when integrating certain functions. This is often impossible, so it's important to know when you can factorize a polynomial and how to do this. In this video, we'll see what we mean by factorization, why it exists, and which cases we can handle. So let's start with an n-degree polynomial. So we start with x to the power n. We can assume without loss of generality that the prefactor equals 1, and then some coefficients times x to the power n minus 1 up till c0. So what do we mean by factorization? Well, we want to split it up in small linear factors. And if we can have our numbers in C, then we know, we'll see later on why, that we can split any polynomial in linear factors only. So we can rewrite our big polynomial as product of terms x minus x1, x minus x2, x minus x3, up to x minus xn. If we don't allow for complex numbers, if we only can use real numbers, then we can do something similar. We can also split up our polynomial in x minus x1, x minus x2, but then we may also encounter quadratic terms of the form x squared plus a1 times x plus b1, x squared plus a2 squared times x plus b2, etc. So let's see some examples. How is this done? Let's do some easy examples. Well, for example, we start with an easy polynomial x squared minus 1. So we start with a coefficient 1, then no linear term, and a minus 1 as c0. Then you know how you can factorize it. This is x squared minus 1 equals x minus 1 times x plus 1. Factorizing may be hard. Checking is always easy because you can multiply out the brackets. So then you get x squared plus x minus x cancelling out minus 1. So indeed x squared minus 1. So checking whether your factorization is correct is always easy. And go over to the next polynomial, x squared plus 1. Well, you know that if you can use only real numbers that you can't factorize it. So then this is already the factorization. It contains only one quadratic term. If you can use complex numbers, then you can factorize this polynomial a bit further to x plus I times x minus y. Because check again, this equals x squared, okay, we have that one, minus ix plus ix, so those cancel out, plus I times minus I, so minus I squared equals minus minus 1 equals plus 1. So that's indeed correct. So here we see the example where we can't factorize further using only real numbers, but where we can go one step further if we can also use complex numbers. So that about second degree polynomials. Let's go one higher. So b3 x cubed minus x squared plus x minus 1. Well, that one is already quite hard to factorize. We have the factorization over here. Let's just check it. We have the x cubed term plus x. We have that one as well over here. And then we have a minus x squared over here, minus 1 over there. Okay, so the factorization is correct. Well, how did we find it? We'll see that later on. But we see that the factorization is correct. And we also see that if we use only real numbers, then we can't go further. And you'll see that we have a product of a linear term and a quadratic term in this case. Well, if you can use complex numbers, then you can go one step further in this third polynomial, because we have already seen the x squared plus 1 over here. We did it over there, that we can factorize that one step further. And then we have a polynomial in terms of only linear factors. So why can we do this? Well, first of all, observe that all those xi here, x1 and x2, etc., if you plug them in P, then if you, the left hand side equals the right hand side. So if you plug them in P, then you see that you get some factor which is 0 over here. So you get on the right-hand side 0 times other factor, so that will be 0 on the right-hand side. Right-hand side equals left-hand side, so left-hand side also 0. So what we see is that all those factors, x1, x2, etc., they are all zeros of the polynomial p. P at xi equals 0 for all I. And then, how are we going to do this? Well, if you know some zero of your polynomial, then you can use long division to divide it out and to make your polynomial 1 degree lower. So then you write your polynomial p as this linear factor x minus xi times q, where you can find q by dividing p divided by x minus xi, and then your q will be 1 degree lower. And you can continue this until you are until you have divided out all your linear factors. Well, furthermore, you know that if you are looking complex, that every polynomial has exactly n zeros. So if you are looking using complex numbers, then you can use this procedure n times. So you can divide out n linear terms. Then you have a product of n factors, which if you will multiply them out gives you an nth degree polynomial. So that's it. So if you have complex numbers, then you can write any polynomial as product of x minus x1, x minus x2, where x1 and x2, etc., are the zeros of the polynomial. Of course, proving this third statement here requires some effort. Now, if you look real, then you don't have this statement, but you can go complex first. And then you notice, well, if x1 is some zero of p, then x1 bar, the complex conjugate, is also a zero. So then you know if you would look complex first that you can write this part of p as x minus x1 times x minus x1 bar. Multiply that out, you get a x squared right here, x minus x bar, and then x minus x1 over here, and plus x1 x1 bar over here. Okay, like that. And then you notice something funny. Well, the x1 times x1 bar is the norm of x1 squared, so that's something real. And x1 plus x1 bar is equals 2 times the real part of x1, so that's something real over here. So then you see that this combination of terms over here is exactly some second degree polynomial. So if you are allowed to use only real numbers, then you see that you're on the background you have x1 and x bar as your zeros, but if you use the combination you see that you get a quadratic factor. So if you have complex numbers you have only linear terms. If you can use only real numbers, then you have linear terms with x minus x1, etc., real numbers, and quadratic terms which are on the back a combination of x minus x1 times x minus x1 bar. So that's why you can factorize like this. So how are we going to do that? Well, n equals 2, second degree polynomial, that's easy. N equals 3 and 4, there are formulas for that, but they are already quite hard. And for n bigger than 4, we can even prove that it is impossible to do this. However, even for bigger cases, it's sometimes possible to reduce the degree of the polynomial, because as you see, this degree of the polynomial, that determines how hard it is to factorize. And in later examples, we will see how we can do this explicitly.